Hello everyone, my name is Parthiv Sparek. I am physics teacher in LP Savani Guru Hope School. Today we are going to discuss the topic electric dipole. Earlier I already talked about that, what is electric dipole. So electric dipole is pair of two charges separated by some distance, say 2a. Okay, separated by some distance 2a. Okay, so the line joining between these two charges is defined the direction of the dipole. By the convection, we are taking the direction minus Q charge to plus Q charge is our direction of the dipole. Okay, so we can write the dipole equation is vector P is equal to the distance between two charges, say 2A, and multiply by the charge of the dipole. Okay, so that is our dipole equation. So we discuss the next subtopic of the electric dipole is the field of an electric dipole. So the field of or electric field of pair of charges, say minus Q and plus Q at any point in space, can be found out from Coulomb's law and the superposition principle. Okay, so the result are simple for the following two cases. First one is when the point is in on the dipole axis, and the second is when it is in equatorial plane of the dipole. Okay, so on the plane perpendicular to the dipole axis through its center, that is called equatorial plane, the electric field at any general point P is obtained by adding the electric field E minus Q due to the charge minus Q and E plus Q due to the charge plus Q by the parallelogram law of vectors. Now we talk about electric field on axial line. So suppose we take two charges or electric dipole, say minus Q and plus Q. So the line joining between these two charges is defined axial line of the electric dipole. Okay, suppose we want to find out electric field on this axial line of any point. Suppose we take here point P. Okay, we want to find out electric field due to the both charges, say plus Q and minus Q. So how we define electric field on point P due to the plus Q charges and due to the minus Q charges? Okay, so let us define. Suppose the center of the electric dipole and the point P, the distance between the center of electric dipole and the point P is given R. Okay, so the distance between two electric charge is suppose 2a, and the point from the center of the dipole is suppose we take r. Okay, so the plus q charge, so the distance between plus q charge and the point P is nothing but, it is suppose this distance is, here is 2a, so here is A and here is also A. Okay, so this distance is nothing but, it is A R minus A. Okay, and the distance between minus Q charge and point P is A plus R. Okay, so here we can write R plus A. Okay, now we want to calculate electric field due to the charge plus Q, electric field at point P due to the charge minus Q. Okay, so let us, we can define. Okay, by one. So the electric field produced at the point P due to the charge plus Q is outward, okay, and the electric field produced at the point P due to the charge minus Q is inward, okay, because it is negative, that's why. Okay, so we take direction in inward. Okay, so both are opposite. Okay, that is because of plus Q charges. So we can take E plus Q, and this field is because of minus Q charges. So here we can write E minus Q. Okay, now we want to find out electric field at point P due to the charge plus Q is given by, we already noted what is the equation of electric field. Okay, so electric field is 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught into plus Q charges divided by the distance between plus Q charges and point P is R minus A whole square. Okay, and electric field due to minus Q charge at point P is given by equation E minus Q because of minus Q charges 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q, so minus is, and the distance between minus Q charges and point P is R plus A whole square. So that is equation number 1, that is equation number 2. Okay, so the total net electric field at the point P is given by E is equal to E plus Q and E minus Q. Okay, now here the total electric field or resultant electric field at the point P due to the charge plus Q and due to the charge minus Q is given by from the equation 1 and equation 2. Okay, now put this value and this value in this equation, so we get resultant electric field at point P. Okay, so we can write from the equation 1 is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 or epsilon naught into Q upon R minus A whole square minus E minus Q is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R plus A whole square. Okay, now with common 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and Q from both the equations. Now we get total or net electric field at point P due to the charge plus Q and minus Q is Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught in bracket 1 over R minus A whole square minus 1 over R plus A whole square. Okay, now we simplify this equation, then we get total electric field is Q open 4 pi epsilon naught. Here it is going to upward and this is going to upward. Okay, from the LCM, then we get R plus A whole square minus R minus A whole square divided by R square minus A square and whole square. Okay, so R square minus A square and whole square. So we get Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Here simplify this equation, R square plus 2RA plus A square minus R square minus 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 plus 2RA
plus a square, okay, divided by, as it is r square minus a square whole square. So we get here r, and r cancel out because of plus minus, a square is cancel out, okay, and 2ra is nothing but it is 4ra. So finally we get the result is q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2ra is equal to 4ra divided by r square minus a square whole square as it is.
So now here we can write
q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 4ra is equal to 2 into 2 ra we can write down, okay, so r square minus a square whole square. So q 2 and a we can write separately, okay, then we get 2 q a, okay, then what we remaining 2r, okay, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square minus a square into whole square, okay. So 2qa is nothing but it is defined electric dipole, so we can write 2aq is equal to p, then 2r as it is, then 4 pi epsilon naught in bracket r square minus a square whole square, okay. Now we assume that the point P is very far from the these two charges, so the distance between the center of the dipole and the point P is very large, so here we neglect r square, neglect a square in compared to r square, okay. So we take here condition r is greater than a, it means the point P is very far from this electric dipole, okay, then we can write r is greater than a, okay. So here what we get, P into 2r divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square, because a square is neglected because of it is very small, okay, so r square into square we get r raised to 4. So here finally we get p into 2r divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into r square r raised to 4. So here 1r and 1r is cancelled out, so we get finally 2p divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r cube, okay. So that is our final equation of total electric field produced at point P due to the charge plus q and due to the charge minus q, okay. So here we get only magnitude, so what is the total direction of this electric field produced on that point P, okay. So the direction of electric field here is minus q to plus q, okay, that is p cap, okay. So that is our final electric field at point P.